afternoon. Welcome to Noonday Prayer here at St. Mary's today. We will be using Noonday Prayer from the Book of Common Prayer found on page 103. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. We will read together by whole verse Psalm 126, found on page 105. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then we were like those who dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue shouts of joy.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the watercourses of the Negev.
Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. This is a reading from the Book of Deuteronomy. You shall put these words of mine in your heart and soul, and you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and fix them as an emblem on your forehead. Teach them to your children, talking about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates, so that your days and the days of your children may be multiplied in the land that the Lord swore to your ancestors to give them, as long as the heavens are above the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This morning I came across this gorgeous Mary Oliver poem that I wanted to share with you. I have refused to live locked in the orderly house of reasons and proofs. The world I live in and believe in is wider than that. And anyway, what's wrong with maybe? You wouldn't believe what once or twice I have seen. I'll just tell you this. Only if there are angels in your head will you ever possibly see one. Mary Oliver's words never fail to hold me on the edge of my seat. She was the writer in residence at Sweetbriar when I was a student there, and I'd like to tell you that I took every opportunity to spend time with her, that I took every class she taught and went to every reading and every workshop. But I could not. I did not spend one moment with Mary Oliver except noticing her walk across the quad. I missed every opportunity I had to interact with her. But I have her words now, and I cannot help but wonder at what her words would mean to me if I had taken time to sit with her and learn from her. I also have several copies of Oliver's work that belonged to my grandmother, and I wonder at why certain pages are turned down or little scraps of paper are tucked into certain poems. I miss the opportunity to ask her about that too. Missed opportunities are something we all wrestle with regularly. Should-haves, could-haves, botched connections, misunderstood words and intentions. You may keep a long list of these lost chances in your heart. I know I do. Sometimes I think that these misses are just the way that things are. I can point to no real error on my part as to why they happened. Some things just don't align. Like, it's not a missed opportunity that I'm not a pro golfer. No amount of practice or training was going to make that happen, and I proved that yesterday as we played top golf for our staff outing. But many times I can look back and see where I just plain messed up and squander the possibility of some kind of wonderful taking shape. Like how I just never showed up to be there with Mary Oliver. Many times I miss things because I'm too busy, and granted, some of my busy is legit, two kids, a dog, work, but often my busyness is simply self-imposed. Sometimes I lose out on an opportunity because I'm just scared or unsure of myself. But I find that I'm most disappointed in myself when I miss an opportunity because I simply lack the imagination to see what is possible. And almost always, the potential love that I'm called to carry with me as a sign on my hand, as an emblem on my forehead, this love that I'm told to hold fast to and share as I move through every minute of all my days. I know that most of my missed opportunities have come when I forget this love. I get locked into the idea that, as Oliver puts it, of an orderly house, that an orderly house is the sum total of how this whole life works. I latch onto systems and methods and formulas that seem provable. I will not budge sometimes from my certainty. Any sense of maybe or what if, I simply brush past, preferring the comfort of what I know or what I believe to know is true. So this morning when I read these lines, I stopped dead in my tracks. I have refused to live locked in the orderly house of reasons and proofs. The world I live in and believe in is wider than that. And anyway, what's wrong with maybe? It feels like to me we are on the edge of something big. Big in this world right now as we re-enter common life. There are certainly important scientific facts and truths that are guiding how we make decisions and we make our plans to gather up again. And those facts and truths are part of the way forward. And I will listen to the scientists and public health experts. It is not a missed opportunity that I am not in their field. You could ask my high school chemistry teachers, both of them, because I tried the class twice and it didn't take either time. But to me, the other crucial part of the way forward is the maybe. Maybe we have the opportunity to try something new, to live more fully into God's dream for us. What if we didn't miss the opportunity this year and a half has offered us to sift away what is not needed, what is broken, to winnow away like chaff that which does not speak to us about the fullness of God's love in God's mercy. This could be the time to set aside ways of being that do not reflect what is best in us, systems that belittle and harm our neighbors, and old beliefs that intentionally or not do not reflect God's all-encompassing and creative love. Maybe we have been gifted the chance to draw wider circles, to set bigger tables, to share with each other those wonders that we have seen, the angels in our own heads. I have exactly zero idea what this will look like, how we will move forward together. But I know something of the one who made this beautiful world, the one who gave us people like Mary Oliver, the one who gave us you and me. The one whose infinite love and possibility those angels in our heads are always whispering to us about. I imagine that what lies ahead could be absolutely amazing if we keep saying maybe. Dear Lord, please let us answer all the maybes ahead with a reflection of that infinite love. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign now and forever."
Amen.
I invite your own prayers and intercessions at this time, said silently or aloud. Offer prayers for all the healthcare professionals hard at work, for students and graduates and their teachers as the school year comes to a close, for those working to restore the fuel supply, and for calm and stability as we navigate these next few days, for all those on our parish prayer list to know the comfort of your love, for the Wilkins family, Lord, we give you thanks for all the blessings of this life. Let us bless the Lord.